myself Hena Shah, assistant professor at LJ Institutes of Engineering and Technology. So today we are going to begin a new topic named sequence and series. So let us begin with its first topic, that is infinite sequence. So a set of numbers written in some particular order is called a sequence. The sequence can be written as U1, U2, U3, UN and so on. So U1 is known as our first term of the sequence and UN is known as our nth term of the sequence. Now let us study its notation. So sequence is denoted by sequence UN, n is equal to 1 to infinity or sequence UN. So these two are the notations of the sequence. Now if our sequence is finite, then it is written as sequence UN n is equal to 1 to m or sequence U1, U2, U3 up to UN. So this is known as our finite sequence. Next, let us study few examples of sequences. So the first is, if sequence n upon n plus 1, n is equal to 1 to infinity is given, then our nth term UN is equal to n upon n plus 1. So this can be written as, if you put n is equal to 1, then you will get U1 as 1 upon 2. If you put n is equal to 2 in this, then you will get U2 as 2 upon 3 and so on. Write your nth term n upon n plus 1, and this is an infinite sequence. So again and so on. So this is your infinite sequence n upon n plus 1. Next, sequence minus 1 raised to n upon n plus 2, n is equal to 1 to infinity. Here your nth term is minus 1 raised to n upon n plus 2. Now if you want to find your u1, u2, etc., start putting n is equal to 1. So if you put n is equal to 1 in this, you will get minus 1 upon 3. Similarly, put n is equal to 2, so you will get minus 1 square. So 1 upon 4 and so on. So this is your infinite sequence minus 1 raised to n upon n plus 2. Next, let us study the sequence cos n pi by 2, where n is starting from 0 to infinity. So your nth term is cos n pi by 2. Now if you put 0 in this, so you will get cos 0. Then if you put 1, you will get cos pi by 2 and so on. So this is your infinite sequence cos n pi by 2. Now let us study the graph of the sequences. So let us begin with graph of sequence n upon n plus 1. So you can have a look at the graph. Next, let us study the graph of minus 1 raised to n upon n plus 2. So here this is a graph of the following sequence. Next, let us study the graph of cos n pi by 2. So this is the graph of cos n pi by 2. Okay, now let us study the limit of a sequence. So a sequence UN has limit n, and it can be written as limit n tends to infinity UN is equal to n, or UN goes to n as n tends to infinity if for every epsilon greater than 0 there is a corresponding integer n, such that if n greater than capital N, then mod UN minus L less than epsilon. Now let us go to the properties of limit of sequences. So if we are given two sequences UN and VN, they are convergent sequences and C is constant, then we can say that limit n tends to infinity UN plus VN is equal to limit n tends to infinity UN plus limit n tends to infinity VN. Next, limit n tends to infinity UN minus VN, that will be equal to limit n tends to infinity UN minus limit n tends to infinity VN. So you can separate the terms in these two. Next, limit n tends to infinity C times UN. So you can take up C common because it is constant. So it will be equal to C times limit n tends to infinity UN. Next, limit n tends to infinity UN into VN will be equal to limit n tends to infinity UN into limit n tends to infinity VN. Next, limit n tends to infinity un upon vn will be equal to limit n tends to infinity un upon limit n tends to infinity vn only if limit of vn should not be equal to 0. Next, limit n tends to infinity un raised to n will be equal to limit n tends to infinity un whole raised to m only if m greater than 0 and un should also be greater than 0. Next, these are some standard limits which we are going to use to solve our examples of sequences. Okay, so next let us study the definition of a convergent sequence. So if a sequence un has a finite limit n, that is un should tends to n, then we can say that the sequence converges or the sequence is convergent. It is denoted as limit n tends to infinity un is equal to l, or un goes to l, which is finite, as n tends to infinity. Then only we can say that our given sequence is convergent. So let us solve one example based on this. Here we have to test the convergence of the sequence 2n minus 7 upon 3n plus 2. So firstly, let us write our un. So our nth term un is equal to 2n minus 7 upon 3n plus 2. Now in order to check the convergence, we will find limit n tends to infinity un. If it is finite, then we can say that the given sequence is convergent. So let us find the limit n tends to infinity un. Put the value of un, that is 2n minus 7 upon 3n plus 2. Now in order to evaluate the limit, we will take out n common from the numerator and denominator. So you will get n times 2 minus 7 upon n upon n times 3 plus 2 by n. So now n and n will get cancelled out. So we will get limit n tends to infinity 2 minus 7 upon n upon 3 plus 2 upon n. Now we know limit n tends to infinity 1 upon n will be equal to 0. So this limit will go to 0, this also will go to 0. So finally what you will get answer as 2 upon 3. And this is finite value. So we can say that the given sequence is convergent. Next, let us study the definition of divergence of a sequence. So if a sequence un has infinite limit, then we can say that the sequence diverges or it is divergent. So it is written as limit n tends to infinity un, that will be equal to plus or minus infinity as n tends to infinity. So if limit of un is infinite, then we can say that it is a divergent sequence. Now let us study one example. Here we have to test the convergence of the sequence 2n plus 1. So let us begin with its solution. So here un is equal to 2n plus 1. So again we will find the limit of un as n tends to infinity. So limit n tends to infinity un, that will be equal to limit n tends to infinity. Put the value of un, that is 2n plus 1. Now if you put n tends to infinity, our limit will go to infinity. Therefore, we can say that the given sequence is divergent. Okay. Next, let us study the definition of oscillation of a sequence. So if the limit of a sequence un is not unique, that is if limit n tends to infinity un has more than one answer, then we can say that the given sequence is oscillatory. So let us study one example of oscillatory sequence. We have to show that the sequence cos n pi by 2 is oscillatory. So let us start the solution. Here un is equal to cos n pi by 2. Now suppose if we find the limit of un. So limit of un will be equal to limit n tends to infinity cos n pi by 2. Now we know cos pi will be equal to minus 1, cos 0 will be equal to 1, right? And cos pi pi by 2 will be equal to 0. So if we put different values of n, we will get three types of answers, that is 0, 1 and minus 1. So limit of a sequence is not unique. Therefore, we can say that the given sequence is oscillatory. Okay. Now, let us solve few more examples based on three types of sequences, that is convergent, divergent and oscillatory sequence. So first example is the sequence n square plus n upon 2n square minus n convergent? So let us start the solution. Un is equal to n square plus n upon 2n square minus n. So let us start finding the limit. Limit n tends to infinity un. Put the value of un, that is n square plus n upon 2n square minus n. Now here you have to take out the maximum degree of n common from the numerator and denominator. So we will take out n square common. So you will get limit n tends to infinity n square into 1 plus 1 by n upon n square times 2 minus 1 upon n. Now this n square will get cancelled out. So you will get the following equation. Now we know limit n tends to infinity 1 upon n is equal to 0. So this will go to 0, this will go to 0. So what you will get the answer of the limit 1 upon 2, which is finite. So we can say that the given sequence is convergent. Let us solve one more example. Here we have to test the convergence of the sequence 10hn. So let us start the solution. Here our nth term is equal to 10hn. Okay. Now let us find the limit of un. So put the value of un, that is 10hn, which can be written as sin hn upon cos hn. Now let us replace the values of sin hn and cos hn. We know that sin hx will be equal to e raised to x minus e raised to minus x upon 2. And cos hx will be equal to e raised to x plus e raised to minus x upon 2. So we will replace x by n and put in this. So 2 and 2 will get cancelled out. And what will remain? E raised to n minus e raised to minus n upon e raised to n plus e raised to minus n. Now what we have done? We have taken out e raised to minus n common. So on taking out common, you will get limit n tends to infinity e raised to minus n, e raised to n upon e raised to minus n minus 1 upon e raised to minus n again common and e raised to n upon e raised to minus n plus 1. So this will get cancelled out and you will get what? E raised to 2n minus 1 upon e raised to 2n plus 1. Again, in the next step, we will take out now e raised to 2n common. So you will get e raised to 2n common 1 minus 1 upon e raised to 2n upon again e raised to 2n common 1 plus 1 upon e raised to 2n. Now these two will get cancelled out and you will get finally the answer as 1, because limit of these two will go to 0. So again we have limit finite. So we can say that the given sequence is convergent. Next, let us solve one more example, that is we have to discuss the convergence of the sequence 2 raised to n. So here our nth term is 2 raised to n. So let us find the limit of un. So it will be equal to limit n tends to infinity 2 raised to n. If you put infinity in this, you will get answer as infinite. So we can say that the given sequence is divergent. Next, let us discuss the convergence of the sequence minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon 2 raised to n. So let us begin with the solution. So here un is equal to minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon 2 raised to n. So let us find the limit of un. So put un, that is minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon 2 raised to n. Now we know that limit n tends to infinity 1 upon 2 raised to n will be equal to 0. So what will finally remain? Minus 1 raised to n. But whenever we put even value of n, you will get answer as 1. and whenever you put odd values, that is 1, 3, 5, 7, you will get answer of limit as minus 1. Therefore, we can say that the limit is not unique. Hence, the given sequence is oscillatory. Okay. Next, let us solve one more example. Here we have to discuss the convergence of the sequence En, where En is equal to n plus 1 upon n minus 1 whole raised to n. And we also have to find the limit of En. So let us start the solution. Here the nth term is n plus 1 upon n minus 1 whole raised to n. So in order to discuss the convergence, we will find the limit. So limit n tends to infinity En, that will be equal to limit n tends to infinity n plus 1 upon n minus 1 whole raised to n. Now again we take out n common from the numerator and denominator. So what will get out common? N raised to n upon n raised to n, and what will remain? 1 plus 1 upon n upon 1 minus 1 upon n whole raised to n. Now these two will get cancelled out. So what we will get? Limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 by n upon 1 minus 1 upon n whole raised to n. Now we'll separate these two. And we know limit n tends to infinity 1 plus 1 upon n whole raised to n will be equal to e. So the numerator will go to e and the denominator will go to e raised to minus 1, because here we have minus. So on simplifying, you will get limit n tends to infinity en will be equal to e square, which is finite. Therefore, we can say that a given sequence is convergent. And limit n tends to infinity en is equal to e square. So, in today's session, we have studied three types of sequences. One is convergent, next is divergent, and the last one is oscillatory sequence, right? And in these three, what we have to do? Firstly, we have to find limit n tends to infinity un. Now there are three parts. If the limit is finite, then we can say that the given sequence is convergent. If the limit is plus or minus infinity, then we can say that the given sequence is divergent. And if the limit is not unique, that is, if we are getting more than one answers of the limit, then we can say that the given sequence is oscillatory. So I hope you have understood throughout the session. Thank you for watching.